Hi friends, it's Shay. Welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I wanted to share 10 different Chrome extensions that are helpful for college and high school students. These are Chrome extensions that I personally use that helped me be more organized in my online courses. So let's just get started. So the first thing is the Kill Newsfeed extension. This is an extension for basically blocking everything on your homepage of Facebook. I'm guilty of mindlessly just typing Facebook and going on Facebook, and this Chrome extension has helped me stop that cycle of mindlessly going on Facebook and scrolling there for hours because there are so many interesting things on Facebook, and the website is designed to kind of reel you in and keep you on there. So this extension is especially helpful if Facebook is your main platform of choice. The second extension is Zotero. So this extension is paired with the actual desktop application, but this is basically for compiling all your research and citations. Before, I would use EasyBib, I think, for my citations, but I had to always just like type in the actual website or the paper, and it didn't feel fully automated. But with Zotero, crazy. So if you go to an actual page or a website, as long as you have the Zotero desktop application open, you could just click on the Zotero Chrome extension and it will automatically save that page onto your desktop application, where if you put it all in one folder, you can just export the whole folder as like APA format, Vancouver style, MLA format, and all of these different formats, and automate that process of making a bibliography. It's also compatible with Google Docs, and this has helped me save so much time and not worry so much about my citations. Yeah, so I highly recommend it if you tend to write a lot of papers for your classes. So the third Chrome extension is called Momentum. I think a lot of people have seen this on that Study Blur community or StudyGram community, where people have this really beautiful desktop when they open a new tab and it says hello, your name, and then it's like on top of this really nice image, and it's an actual Chrome extension called Momentum. If you don't have your own planning system, there's actually a to-do list thing within that actual page. So you can write down everything that you need to do and use that as a to-do list. I think this is great for people who are always on Google Chrome and always just doing things on the internet for school. So one thing that's really saved a lot of time for me in online school is Video Speed Controller. On YouTube, I think you can change the speed of the video like 1.25 or 1.5 or 2 times, but on Video Speed Controller, you can go from like 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, and so on. So you can speed up your video. Any video that's on a web page under Google Chrome, you can speed it up. And I think it's great for when there isn't a speed up option within the website that you're using, or if 2x speed is too fast for you, you can always speed it up just by like 1.3. And even though it's not such a big difference, you're still saving a lot more time if you feel like your prof is talking too slowly in the video. So the next thing is voice-in-voice typing. And this is great because if you're not a fast typer and you can speak clearly, you can use this to actually type up things or type up notes. If you're recording conversations, that sounds kind of creepy, but if you're recording lectures, you could just turn the voice-in-voice thing and then it'll type out the whole lecture out for you. I don't know how accurate this might be, but if you're like a slow typer, this might be a great option for you. And then the next one is Grammarly. I think a lot of people have heard of this and use it, but if you don't know, Grammarly is this Chrome extension that helps you correct your grammar and spelling across many different web pages. If you get the Grammarly Pro, it'll actually help you write better as well, and I like to put my essays into Grammarly and see if there are any typos that I've missed, because I think it's really easy to miss typos or grammar errors and stuff like that. And it's also great because when you're sending emails to profs, I feel like I get so anxious about if I have grammatical errors in the email, so the Grammarly extension kind of takes care of that for me. Next thing is Adblock. It's great because it blocks ads across so many different pages. I think ads are basically like everywhere now, and that's how websites make money. I kind of feel bad for recommending this, but it blocks ads off of YouTube videos and all of these other things, so you're not wasting your time watching ads, and you can get to places way faster. Next thing is teleparty. This is not really productivity related, but if you're in college and you want to watch Netflix with other people, teleparty kind of helps with syncing Netflix, so then you can watch a movie together even if you're not in the same room or you're not in the same city. And there's a chat option too, so you could just chat while you're watching a movie and you don't really need to be on FaceTime and like click play at the same time. It just automatically does that for you, and there's a way for you to communicate with your friends. The next extension is called Go Fucking Work. It's a block site extension. You basically make a list of sites that you don't want to go on for a certain period of time, and whenever you try to type in those websites on Chrome and click enter, it'll just take you to a page saying that this site is blocked. And it's great because if you tend to mindlessly go on YouTube, Instagram, or Facebook on Google Chrome, then this kind of helps with stopping that cycle so you can't actually scroll on it and waste time on it. And the last Chrome extension is called Toby. And this is a way to organize your tabs. I know there's a specific way to organize your tabs within the Chrome app. Toby is a more powerful version of that. So if you have a lot of tabs open, or if you need to open a lot of tabs and save it for later, instead of saving each website as a bookmark, you can use Toby to create a group of sites that you want to open at the same time and organize those tabs that way. I know with tiny little computer screens, it can get overwhelming when you have a lot of Chrome tabs open. So that's what I like to use it for. And when I'm writing papers, I do have a lot of tabs open with different research articles and different online sources. So Toby kind of helps organize all of that in one space. So these were the top 10 Chrome extensions that I really liked. If you want more Chrome extension reviews or recommendations, please let me know in the comments below, and also like this video for more content like this. Thank you so much for watching until the very end of the video, and I hope you have a sunny day.